Microsoft Excel is hugely popular for business users all over the world, and for the past 10 years, I've shown thousands of people how to master its features. But I've always had one frustrating challenge. How do I generate practice datasets? When I learn new Excel skills or I make new videos, finding the right dataset has always taken me ages. Sure, I can search online, but that often means countless hours of scrolling to find something that's just right for me. That is, until now. I've discovered a brand new way to generate custom data in seconds. And with this method, you'll be able to create the data you need, whether you're trying to practice your Excel skills for a career change, or you're building a portfolio to land new work. Let me show you exactly how to do it. I'll start by looking for a sample dataset of e-commerce transactions. So in the past, I'd have searched a site like Kaggle for sample data. So there are multiple e-commerce datasets on Kaggle. But I've got to browse through all of the details and look at the columns like this to see if they match what I need. And even if there's something that I like, I can't customize it any further. So when I download the CSV file, it's a fixed file that I can't modify further. So I get what I get. So I'm going to turn to ChatGPT. You've probably heard a lot about how ChatGPT can create images, summarize text, help you write, search the web, and even get detailed insights by doing deep research to create in-depth reports from online information. But I've found that it's also very good at creating custom datasets. However, before we jump into making our first dataset, let me quickly point out that I'm a Plus subscriber, which means I get O1 for advanced reasoning, O3 Mini for fast advanced reasoning, and O3 Mini High, which is great at coding and logic. But you don't need to use any of these models to follow along because the default GPT-4o model is going to be perfect for our needs. And you can access this for free at chatgpt.com. Okay, let's start a new chat. I'm going to type my prompt into this box. We want to make sure to tell ChatGPT that we want the data in a table that we can preview here and also download as a CSV file to use in Excel. I find that it helps to give it a bit of context. I'd like your help to generate a sample data set with 1,000 rows of data that I can see here in a table and also directly download as a CSV file. Now I want to add a new paragraph, so I'll press Shift and Enter twice. And that's because I want to give it a few more instructions. So the dataset will show e-commerce orders that track purchases across multiple product categories with data on order status, payments, and customer regions. Make it realistic in terms of the distribution of data. So I also want to define the dataset more specifically. So I'm going to add 15 columns with names that I want to see in the dataset. If you don't have any specific columns that you want to use, you could also say something like, use your best judgment to create at least 10 columns to suit this dataset. And now we're ready with a prompt. I could either hit enter or press this arrow. So ChatGPT is going to analyze my request and then create a dataset for me. So it will take a bit of time to do the analysis, but once it's done, you can have a look at it right here inside the chat. Now, we can expand the table by clicking on this button. Then we can see more of the data set here, as well as the history of the chat on the right. So I can scroll down to see how many rows there are. And you see 1,000 rows with all the data inside the data set. We can also see the columns if I scroll to the right. So let's try to be realistic with the data, because if the shipment is pending, there is no shipping date or delivery date. Now, I can also click on this button to view the analysis that it did. And it shows us the Python code that it used to create the dataset. Now, I don't actually know how to code in Python, so I'm really grateful that ChatGPT just knows how to do it. What this also means is that we can change the code to generate more rows. So let's close the analysis window, and I'll reduce the size of this preview table. Then I'll ask ChatGPT to make a bigger dataset. Now, increase the size to 10,000 rows while keeping the same column headings. And I'll hit enter. So now it will go off and do some more analysis. And you can see it's called it the large e-commerce orders dataset. So it says, I have generated the larger dataset with 10,000 rows and displayed it for you. You can download the CSV file using the link below. So that's great. We've got an even bigger dataset to work with. And I'll download it by clicking on the link. And now I'll open it in Excel. Now that it's inside Excel, I'll press Ctrl T to turn this into a table. Click OK, change the format, and then press Ctrl down to see how many rows there are. And there are in fact 10,001 rows because there's a header row at the top as well. But what if I want to generate a custom dataset right inside the spreadsheet so I don't have to export the file and then import it into Excel? That way, I could just keep chatting with the data to shape it to my needs, whether it's to add new columns, change the date ranges, or expand the number of rows. Now, I know it's possible to do this inside Excel, but you have to be subscribed to Microsoft 365, and you also have to pay more for the new Copilot option. However, the good news is I found a fantastic free tool that lets you create new datasets quickly and also analyze them in a familiar spreadsheet interface. Check out my next video here to find out about this exciting new tool.